It's Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. Are you ready to make some super cute ice cream carts? We're using the brand new set called Sweet Ice Cream. Now, this also has a coordinating punch and unbelievably super cute, adorable designer series paper. One of my favorite things. So I've got a card I'm going to make for you today. We're going to use the thank you and make a thank you card. And then I have several birthday cards and a few other thank you cards to share with you today. I always like to give you a bunch of ideas with one stamp set and the coordinating products so that you have lots of ideas. So lots of tips to share, primarily with stamping this and punching it with the coordinating punch, because it's one of those punches where it punches out two images at one time. And sometimes that can be a little tricky. So I've got some tips for you to show you how to best punch your images without wasting a lot of paper. And then I think you're really going to like the cards. So I think without further ado, we got to flip this camera down and get stamping because we've got a lot to do today. Hang on 1 second. Just real quickly before we start stamping, I want to show the products we're using. It's part of the Ice Cream Corner Suite. Now this is a fun suite because it has the Sweet Ice Cream stamp set, along with the coordinating punch, and the paper is so cute. And then a few other things. Sprinkle, or what, I'm not even sure what they call these. Sprinkles make some shaker cards, which I think I'll do sometime in the next coming months, and some great ribbon. But before we get to stamping, I wanna just show you the designer series paper. So it's kind of divided into two groups here. We've got this one that has the ice cream cones and the popsicles. And as always, they have these great backsides. And I love that they're somewhat neutral, so you could really use these on other things as well. I love that. And I like them all, but this one is more kind of a watercolor splotchy look, I guess. So lots of fun papers. I have cards I'm going to share with you today using all of these different papers. We're going to make one, and then I've got, probably 5 or 6 cards to show you other than that. You know, the one thing I really like to do is when I create a card and share it with you, I like to share lots of stamping tips, but then I like to show other examples using the same products, because I don't want you to ever, you know, love something and buy it just to make one card. We want to make sure that you have lots of ideas to make lots of different things. Now, just real quick, this is what the front of this catalog looks like that just came out on January 5th. If you do not have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator and you would like a copy of this super awesome catalog, hop over to my website, klompenstampers.com. Up at the top, you can click on catalogs and you can request a free copy of this. I would love to send you one. Okay. That's enough of that stuff. Let's get stamping. So I think what we're going to do is dive into first off using the punch. Now, I always like with these, I call them multi-image punches. I don't know, this is just my name that I like to call them. But sometimes they're a little confusing because, you know, we've got two pieces here. Now, I know some people go through great lengths trying to stamp both and punch both at the same time, but I think it's kind of hard. And to me, it takes way too much time. I do better doing one thing at a time. So what we're going to do is stamp our ice cream first. Now with this type of punch, you want to always flip it over. Sometimes you can see better if you stick paper in there. And you want to look at which way you need to put your image on the scrap paper to be able to easily punch it out. Because if I was to stamp way over here and then I'd come here to punch it, I'd be wasting all of this. But if I punch it at this side, and it needs to be with the bottom of that ice cream pointing that way, like so, now you can see when I put it into the punch here, I have very little waste, and I'm able to easily line it up. So it's kind of like understanding the way your punch works before you, I'm stuck on there, before you stamp. So let me try to explain that a little bit better. That was terracotta tile, and now we've got cinnamon cider. Now for this one, for this ice cream cone, notice that it's kind of angled that way. The shorter end of the triangle is down here. And same thing, when I put it in, I want to stamp over on that side of the paper, kind of at the angle it is. Because here too, if I stamped here, I'd waste that paper. Or if I stamped it at a different angle, I might not even be able to get the punch in there. So to show you what I mean, we're gonna stamp it and see how I'm coming way over to the right bottom. And then when I stick it in there, again, we have very little waste. So that's what I mean by, you know, kind of understanding the way that punch goes. And you can do that by just flipping it over and kind of paying a little bit of attention to where it goes. So that's that. Then let's see here. Let's go ahead. I should have stamped this first. It's a little bit easier, but we've got our little hash marks or whatever you want to call that to kind of add some dimension to our cone. And then all ice cream needs sprinkles. So we have the stamp that adds the sprinkles. So there's our ice cream cone. Now I'm going to go ahead and just use a little bit of adhesive. What I'm going to do is put just a little tiny bit. Come on. Oh, there we go. Not more than way up at the top of our cone. And then I can lay this piece on there like so. And that way, okay, moving around, there is our cute little ice cream cone. Now we're going to make a card using that piece. So let's go ahead and grab this. This is a 1-inch strip here. And now for this piece, I am going to do thank you. Now I know I said we can make adorable birthday cards, which there's that great happy birthday, but there's also a thank you. And all the other samples that I have to show you say happy birthday. So I thought, let's for this one, go ahead and use thank you. So we're gonna stamp that. This is just, like I said, 1-inch piece. We're gonna trim it, okay? It's bigger than I need, and you'll see why here in a second. So we're gonna do thank you. And then right underneath, let's see, it's kind of hard to see without my head straight over it, but then I'd block the camera. We're gonna, so we have thank you with sprinkles on top. Now I have another piece here, and this is Bermuda Bay. And what we're gonna do is just add this. This one is 1 1/8, I believe. Now, don't worry so much about remembering all these measurements. I will have a blog post that goes with this project. Again, the link will be right, it's like right down there in the video description. It'll take you over to my website or my blog post, and you'll see pictures of this card and the other ones I'm going to share with you today. But it, most importantly, it'll list the card recipe for you. So all my cutting dimensions, all the products I use, like to try to make it super easy for you to just kind of follow along with me. And what I'm going to do after I've put these together, and you know, I probably could have pre-cut this because I think I know I want it to be, oops, don't use a scoring blade, it doesn't cut very long. We want it to be 4 1/4. So there we have that and that piece. Now our card is going to be real simple. Took a piece of this super adorable, fun designer series paper with the ice cream cones on it. We'll layer it over some old olive. Now this paper has a ton of different colors in it. So whichever colors you want to use, and then put some on there. And what I'm going to do is just kind of throw this on here at an angle. You know, sometimes angles are fun because it just gives things a little bit of different look to it as opposed to everything always being so centered and symmetrical. And then we're going to add this piece. And I did cut it down to 4 1/4. So it is going, well, it should fit. Oh, you know what? I bet I cut that a little bit short. That's okay. It totally works. We're going to go ahead, try to get that straight. There we go. You know, this kind of creating on the fly as we go sometimes doesn't come out exactly how we're thinking. That's why you want to make sure you check that card recipe over on my website. So thank you with sprinkles on top. And then let's go ahead and pop this ice cream cone up like so. And look at how cute that turned out. Now for the inside of the card, I have a piece that is 3 3/4 by, 5. So I'm going to layer that as well. Now I don't always layer the inside, but sometimes, especially when it's real simple, if you do that, when you've got these fun coordinating colors like that, it just kind of adds some fun to the inside as well. Now I'm not going to stamp this because I'm going to show you another card that I've done that already, so you'll get the idea. So let me grab the other ones. So here's the happy birthday version I use. Now you can see this is just the other ice cream paper. This one I went that way, that one I went that way. It doesn't really matter. But otherwise, the design is basically the same. And here you can see how in the inside, I also added some ice cream cones. And I just kind of stacked 3 scoops on that one. And I put dimensionals on it also. I don't always add dimension on the inside of the card. But, you know, there's no harm in it. Even when it's closed, it's not going to get too smushed down, but it kind of adds a nice inside to it. So there are those two. And then there was also our popsicle piece. Now, there are popsicle stamps in this as well. Now, you do have to cut those with the scissors. I wish we had a punch for that as well. But it is two pieces, so it's real easy to put the multicolor on there. And I did the same basic layout. I just turned it this way. So we've got Happy Birthday. And again, I popped up a couple of popsicles on the inside. So there's that. Now, I also went ahead and I made three other cards using the three other prints in this paper. Kind of that watercolor splotch. You know, we could use it with ice cream cones or whatever, but I thought it was just fun paper. So I went ahead and just layered it with coordinating colors, and I needed to make a bunch of thank you cards. So I just used my thank you along with a die and cut that out and popped it up on dimensionals. So that's the only stamping, but it makes some quick and easy thank you cards. So I hope you like those projects. I love the colors. I love everything about the stamp set and how easy it is to create with. So if you have any questions or need help with anything with card making or stamping up, reach out to me. You can leave me a comment, hop over to my website. I would love to hear from you. And leave me a comment if you like these projects. I always love to hear from the people that watch. And if you're a subscriber and follow me often or watch me often, thank you so much. And make sure to share my videos with your stamping friends. So until I stamp with you again, have a stamp happy day.